I have two scenarios for Ethereum. First is that Ethereum can kill itself and kill all projects which are built on Ethereum. Another scenario is that Ethereum could become a cryptocurrency similar to Bitcoin with stored value, where you could store money, guys. And if you are interested, keep tuned and watch this video. So like I mentioned, guys, I have two scenarios for Ethereum. The first is that Ethereum could kill itself. But before I start discussing it, as always in my price prediction videos, first what I will do, I will quickly give an overview to those who doesn't know what is Ethereum, guys, and I will explain you what is Ethereum so you understand the importance of Ethereum first. So Ethereum currently, as you can see, it is second biggest cryptocurrency. It has a price of $946 in recent 24 hours. Its price is growing. It went up by 15%, and in 7 days it went up by 32%. Market cap of Ethereum is $109 billion, guys. So $109 billion currently are in Ethereum, and this is because a lot of different applications are being built on Ethereum. These applications or these cryptocurrency projects which you can see here on CoinMarketCap or for example on CoinGecko, 80% of these projects are built on Ethereum blockchain. These are built on contracts. We could randomly select some token here, ZB token, okay? First one, which is hundreds in the Ethereum. And here when you open up, guys, and how you can discover whether it's built on Ethereum or not, is first thing you look here and you can see that this is token. If it's a token, it is built on some other blockchain technology, like I already was mentioning you in my previous videos. So it doesn't have this particular project, it doesn't have its native blockchain technology, as it is a token and it is built on some other blockchain. That is one thing, how you can see straight away that this is Ethereum. Second thing is that if you will click here on Explorers, you will see Etherscan. With all blockchains which have been built on Ethereum blockchain technology, they have contract addresses. If we click here into Etherscan, guys, it will open us an Etherscan, and on Etherscan you can check all blockchains which are being built on Ethereum, or not all blockchains, but all projects which are being built on Ethereum, and you can see those contract addresses for protocol or for that token which has been built off on Ethereum. And as you can see, for this particular ZB token, contract address is this one. And here you can see more information on Etherscan about all different projects. Like I already mentioned you, as you see, decimal points is 18 decimal points, and maximum supply, or pretty much how many of these ZB tokens ever will be created, or how many they are predicted in this contract, guys, which is in their code, is 2,100,000,000. So as you can see, how many holders are here, and by holders they mean that on Ethereum, Etherscan is scanning how many Ethereum addresses are there which are holding this particular token, and that's how they easily can detect how many holders are there, just by how many people are holding or how many Ethereum addresses are holding these tokens. And second thing, you can see transfers, or this is amount of transactions ever done with this token. And in this scenario, ZB token ever had 57,229 transactions. And each specific contract address is created for specific token. We could check another one if you want to do so, but this is how it works on Ethereum blockchain technology, because you could create a contract, you create how many tokens you want, and if you would like me to create and show you how you can create your own ERC20 token, how you can pretty much copy code, just modify a little bit it, and you can create your own token with your own name and with your own total supply, just ask me in comments and I will create a video on that as well. So yes, guys, this is what is Ethereum blockchain technology. So lots of, like I already mentioned, 80% of these coins which you can see and which are being developed currently, there are over 10,000 of them, guys. They are developed on Ethereum blockchain technology, and they are tokens. They are protocols written on Ethereum blockchain. However, some of them, as you see, KNOX, FS, this is a coin. This is not built on Ethereum. If we check some other, let's say IZE, whatever it is, guys, let's open it up. This is also, if you click here on Explorer, you can see it is Etherscan, and here is also contract number for this token here, which you can copy and which you can also verify. So this is also been built on Ethereum. This is how easily you can check them. So now I will tell you my prediction. First one was that I mentioned, guys, that Ethereum can kill itself. Yes, that's what I believe in, that Ethereum could really kill itself, as many of these projects, which you can see here, they all are being built on Ethereum, which is very important. But currently, Ethereum price is growing. But the problem with the price is, I'm not saying that it is bad that Ethereum's price is going up in price or Ethereum is going up in price, but I'm saying that this could be a problem for Ethereum blockchain technology and all other these applications or other these cryptocurrencies which has been built on Ethereum blockchain. And this is because of the reason, guys, that they all use Ethereum blockchain technology, and transactions on all these projects and transactions between these tokens which are being built here on Ethereum of these projects, guys, they use Ethereum, and transactions as the Ethereum price is growing or going up are becoming more and more expensive, which could be a huge problem for Ethereum itself. Because, for example, if you will try to send now, for example, or exchange or swap Ethereum or ERC20 tokens at these prices when Ethereum is going to $1,000, it could destroy these other applications which are smaller, because in some scenarios, for example, sending other smaller coin or other smaller token of another smaller cryptocurrency project, it could be useless pretty much or overpriced. Similarly, if you will try to send Ethereum, and I am sending Ethereum and doing Ethereum transactions every single day, I have noticed that they have become very expensive. And just yesterday I was paying transaction of $40 just for one Ethereum transaction, because Ethereum's price is going up. So this is why I think that Ethereum could kill itself, or Ethereum's price, because it's going up, it could kill itself only because of this reason. And this could also affect hugely all other cryptocurrencies. Like I mentioned, there are about 80% of them here in cryptocurrency, guys, 80% from about 10,000 projects which are already have been built in cryptocurrency space, they are built on Ethereum blockchain technology, or pretty much they are using Ethereum contract. And that could be a huge problem if Ethereum's price goes up. And also in transacting in Ethereum in general, guys, it would become very expensive. That's why Ethereum could kill itself. That's clear, guys. But another thing I said, that there is kind of positive scenario, that Ethereum could become stored value project similar to Bitcoin. And exactly because of that reason, that projects would not want to use Ethereum for creating or developing on Ethereum blockchain because of very expensive transactions, people could start investing in Ethereum and start using it similar to Bitcoin, and then Ethereum's price would go up. And now, guys, I will give you my price prediction for Ethereum, what I think where it will go in this bull market. My price prediction is from 5,000 to 6,000 at maximum, guys, it will go in this bull market. And this is just because of reasons that if it will go even any expensiver, guys, then Ethereum blockchain technology will become pretty much useless. This is how I see it, because no one will want to use Ethereum for sending or for anything, because transactions will be so very high at five. If Ethereum's price will be 5,000 or 6,000, just imagine yourself, if you have been using Ethereum blockchain technology, how expensive would it be to use Ethereum or send Ethereum or swap them by using even Uniswap and so on and so forth. So yes, guys, but this is just my opinion. Don't judge me too harsh. And if you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you're new, and see you in the next one.